When you are digitizing analog video, which frame size should you choose? All formats starting with HD1 provide enough pixels to capture anything from VHS to broadcast quality television, but if you want to stay close to the standards recommended by the International Telecommunication Union, choose the ones that have 704 or 720 pixels per line. These numbers are identical for both digital NTSC and digital PAL, and for both 4x3 and 16x9 frame aspect ratios. You may wonder, how does this work? This is because in video, pixels are often non-square, they're rectangular. It is very important to know the shape of the pixels if you want to ensure that the proportions of your video remain correct and that people and objects are not stretched or squeezed. Let us see how it works in case of old-school 4x3 NTSC. The first option is 704x480 frame. This is what you might see on a DVD. In this case, pixel aspect ratio comes down to 10 over 11 or 0.91 decimal. So the pixels are a little narrower than a square. The second option is 720x480 frame, but only the 704x480 area is used for active image. The remaining portion is not visible on a regular TV set and can be cropped. In this case, the proportions of the image are defined by the 704x480 area, just like in the previous case. This is the most likely case you will be dealing with when digitizing video from analog VCR or analog camcorder, as well as when capturing video from a DV camcorder. The third option is 720x480 frame, and all this area is used for active image. In this case, pixel aspect ratio comes to 8 over 9 or about 0.89 decimal. If you have the camcorder that you use to shoot your videos, you can verify accuracy of the chosen pixel aspect ratio by shooting a square or a round item, making a screenshot, bringing it in a photo editing app, and rotating the item 90 degrees in a new layer. Which one looks more round to you? If all this seems too complex, there is an option 4. VGA is a computer standard that was introduced by IBM in 1987. It captures all of the scan lines of NTSC video, and its horizontal resolution is more than enough to faithfully represent broadcast quality TV or Super VHS video. The best of all, it uses square pixels. Notice that black borders have been removed automatically, confirming the result of the prior test that they do not belong to the active frame area. This frame size is not valid for DVD video, but it works great for YouTube upload. When you create a video, say to upload it to YouTube, do not forget to specify pixel aspect ratio in the encoder settings. Please subscribe to be notified of my new videos in which I will go over compression options in more detail. Thanks for watching.